Two very humiliating experiences took place in our modern history. One was the Japanese invasion that lasted for 14 years, and the other was the siege of the International Megatians by the Eight Nation Alliance. Today we will talk about this invasion in the late Qing Dynasty. According to historical records, after the Western powers invaded China, there was a group photo of the Eight Nation Alliance. This photo is a hard evidence showing the invasion of the Western powers. According to the records at the time, there were actually 9 people in the photo. So who is the extra one? At first, Britain, France, the United States, Russia, Germany, Austria, Italy and Japan are the 8 nations forming an alliance that invaded China. After their invasion, they burned and looted, and committed all sins, especially after the alliance forces captured Beijing, the capital of the Qing government. Seeing the prosperous scenes the 8 nation alliance forces showed covetous jiao beams in their eyes. Countless treasures have been looted by these barbarians. The photo was taken after they captured this war. Many countries only sent troops in a symbolic manner. The Italian army did not even have 100 people. However, the Japanese army sent over 20,000 people. It can be seen that Japan's aggressive ambitions to invade China have long been evident, like the intention of Sima Zhao, which is known by everyone. At that time, the Qing government failed in the naval battle against Japan, and the Western powers immediately saw the decline of China. Then a wave of looting China was blown up. In the above-mentioned countries, under the pretext of putting down the rebels, they entered China and seized the wealth. At that time, the actual power of the late Qing dynasty, Empress Dowager Cixi, fled the city of Beijing with the emperor in a hurry. The ancient capital, with hundreds of years of culture, was fallen into the hands of the invaders. Playing the tragic history of the time, after the Germans entered the city, they killed people upon seeing them, regardless of gender and age. The French people used guns to force people moving into the alleys, and then shot all of them. The Beijing city at that time became a real hell on earth. The corpses were everywhere. They also raped women. At that time, the daughter of a high official of the Qing government was raped by over a dozen people. Later on, the whole family committed suicide in shame. Finally, the Qing government signed an unequal treaty with these powers. Not only would they not be held accountable, but they would also be compensated for hundreds of millions of money. This is the biggest insult to our country's history. At 7 o'clock in the evening, the French entered the Yilan Mingyilan Park and immediately began to rob. The next day, the British joined the ranks. The Japanese ships gradually showed the advantage of having faster speed and rapid rate of fire, and the situation began to appear one-sided. The Beiyang fleet lost 5 warships. Although 5 ships of the Japanese fleet were severely damaged, all of them returned to their home port. The battle lasted for more than 5 hours. Around 2 p.m. in the afternoon, the Qiyuan ship of the Beiyang fleet was sunk. By around 5 p.m. on the 8th of July, the Japanese invaders suddenly bombarded Wanping City. The Chinese defenders fought and resisted, and a national war of resistance broke out. The Lukou-Chiao incident was not an accidental event or a skirmish, but an inevitability due to Japan's policy towards the mainland and its prepared and premeditated actions. The Japanese fascist group believed that conquering China was the key step in their ambition to subdue the world. Therefore, the total war on China was initiated, which contributed to the formation of the fascist axis that consisted of Germany, it first, of the Japanese Independent Guards, reinforced by its reserve troops, continued to attack the North Camp. In the early morning on the 19th, the Japanese army completely occupied the North Camp. At that time, given the serious situation incurred by the Japanese invasion, in the midst of Sino-Japanese military conflict, Chiang Kai-shek and his KMT party insisted on the principle of calming the inside as the prerequisite to fending off the outside, as well as the policy of non-resistance towards Japan. Therefore, when the Japanese army surrounded the North Camp, the 7th Brigade of the Northeast Army, with more than 7,000 people who stationed there, showed no resistance due to the command of non-resistance. However, some officers and soldiers felt unbearable, and fought back in self-defense. 24 Japanese soldiers were injured or lost. The self-defense by some of the patriotic soldiers of the 7th Brigade became the prelude to the anti-Japanese war officially taking place later on.
The helpless populace was trapped by the city walls. We could not flee. The Japanese soldiers went berserk. They raped and tortured. They killed and butchered. In one of the bloodiest massacres of recorded history, they murdered 40,000 men. Those who lived might better have died, for the horror of their twisted and torn bodies was worse than death. These scenes were photographed by an American missionary and smuggled out of China after the rape of Nanking. This nightmare of cruelty was all the more horrible because it was deliberately planned by the Japanese high command to tear the heart out of the Chinese people, once and forever.
日军又从中日双方都承认具有中立地位的安全区内搜捕数万青年，绑赴下关煤炭厂枪杀，用机枪扫射，然后在堆积如山的尸体上浇洒煤油，纵火焚烧。 由于日军疯狂的强奸屠杀，惊恐万分的女人和孩子们纷纷涌入安全区，最多时超过10,000人。实际上，安全区对妇女来说，并非真正的安全之地。日军强行闯入安全区，到金陵女子学院强奸妇女，抢劫钱财。在占领后的一个月中， 南京市内就发生了2万起左右的强奸事件，连8、9岁的幼女和70多岁的老妪都不能幸免。许多妇女在惨遭蹂躏后，又惨遭杀害。日军暴行的高潮从1937年12月13日攻占南京开始，持续了6周，在大屠杀中， 有30万以上的中国平民和战俘被日军杀害，约2万中国妇女遭日军奸淫，南京城的1/3被日军纵火烧毁，南京城变成了人间地狱，而这场惨绝人寰的大屠杀，成为了人类文明史上最黑暗的一页。
九州方圆，华夏风云都汇聚到这个地方。千载岁月，百年奋斗，才迎来了这个时刻。曾经沧海，大浪淘沙，历史的洪流选择了这些人物。那时候，无论你在什么地方，都会有一种特别的感受：中国人 无论过了多少年，都会记得这样一个声音。
我们中华人民共和国中央人民政府今天胜利了。
熟悉的旋律，熟悉的镜头，我们共同拥有的今天就是从这一刻开始的。
China, a nation undergoing a new cultural revolution at the dawn of the 21st century.This epic journey from the air will reveal a nation in transition as millions migrate for new lives to megacities being built at record pace. China, a 5,000-year-old civilization in a hurry. Over the last three decades, it has modernized faster than any other country.At the heart of this transformation is one city, Shanghai. It's now China's most populous city, its financial hub, and the world's busiest port.24 million Shanghai residents speak their own dialect and travel round on one of the biggest transportation systems in the world. It's the rapid rise of its skyscrapers that's really caught the world's imagination.
今天是中国清明节嘛，我们就非常，怀着一种心情，非常那个，这个特殊的心情吧，去福寿园祭拜一下已逝的长辈。
The Li family is joining more than 3 million people in Shanghai on a pilgrimage to pay respects to their dead. It's called tomb sweeping.
我想简单来说，这个就不能忘本吧，应该是这样一种情节，啊，这个祖先给了我们身体，我想更给了我们灵魂，啊，所以通过这样的形式，来把我们祖先留给我们的这么好的传统，能够传承下去。
Used to take 14 hours.Now you can get there in just over 5 hours. At speeds upwards of 180 miles per hour. And for families like the Wangs, this cutting-edge transportation is critical for their New Year exodus. Their hometown of Tsitsiha is in the far northeast.A distance of 950 miles. A journey that would take 36 hours by conventional transport, but not anymore. The bullet train's immense speed is achieved with new electrified track across China.
我和他妈俩
和这姑姑当中非常惦记着他们，嗯，走了这么多年了，过年了他们回来找我们，非常的高兴，一家人都聚到一起了。
Chinese New Year takes place at the start of spring. For the new urban middle class, the summer brings a new Western-style holiday into their calendar, the beach holiday. The world's biggest indoor swimming pools here too. A giant wave machine is its main attraction. The Chinese name for this incredible sight is dumpling soup. Chinese aren't splashing out on beach holidays. They're turning to television and cinema for their entertainment. China's movie market is now the world's second largest, with tens of thousands of cinema screens. And homegrown production is booming. This is the coastal city of Shenzhen, in southeast China. Thirty-five years ago, this was a small town with a population of 300,000 people. Twelve million people live here now, feeding the largest manufacturing base in the world. Nearly 700 million Chinese live in cities now. Shenzhen also suffers high levels of pollution. Their problem isn't coal power stations and factories, but the 3 million vehicles congesting the roads. The city's solution is to build a huge fleet of electric buses. Fully charged, these zero-emission machines run for 150 miles. Electric vehicles are not new, but the scale of implementation is. Thousand buses operate throughout the city. All are controlled from a central computer under the command of Yan Guangxing.
This room is our entire Shenzhen City electric vehicle monitoring center. We now have 74 factory plants in Shenzhen. Like this map, this red line represents a car. Every car and every factory we can monitor.
New technology is key to not only the transport systems in China's cities, but also to transporting the Chinese to places beyond the confines of China, and even our planet. New technological advances have seen them enter the space race with the US and Russia for the first time. 的 space race. From the first Chinese astronaut to walk in space in 2008, now they're building their own space station. Back on Earth, in Singlong, near the capital of Beijing, the Chinese are also mapping the heavens with high-tech telescopes. After all, they were among the planet's first astronomers. This is the LMOST telescope, an incredibly powerful telescope designed to capture wide swathes of space. When fully operational, it will become the world's most powerful telescope of its class. It will map 10 million stars in our galaxy and a million other galaxies beyond. But even LMOST will soon be dwarfed by one of China's latest engineering marvels. 1,112 miles southwest in the mountains of Guizhou, China is building a telescope that will take another cosmic leap into the future. With a diameter of 1,600 feet, it will be more than 1.5 times as big as the world's largest telescope. This gargantuan eye for the night sky will see extraplanetary transmissions 1,000 light years away.
宋朝时代，1501054年，我们观测到了一个克星，就突然天空大放光芒，实际就是一个超新星。这个望远镜开光之后，可能我们选的第一个目标就是看一眼那个东西，这就是现代、未来。
For the telescope to operate effectively, it's located in a remote area with no electronic interference or noise pollution. But the engineers are working at the very edge of what's possible.
我们就像小蜘蛛一样，我们要结一个500米的大网，再跟网有6000多根索来组成，总的重量有1500多吨。如果说其中一个面锁，它在设计或者施工过程中它张拉的不到位，我们这个球形就没法成型。最大的风险就是我在现场100多号工人都要在60米以上的高空在作业，这个风险就是简直就是让人无法想象。就我们看见这种走钢丝的人，觉得他们风险很高，实际上我们的人天天都在走钢丝。 我们作为工程师来说，其实我们不愿意做超级大项目，因为困难很高，非常难。但是呢，因为受这种地理条件的影响，局限性，我们必须要做这种大的时候，我们也愿意去做。其实我们都一直在挑战自我，挑战自我，我们要看我们到底能够做多大，做成多么好。
China is now well and truly part of a new space race, and efforts to understand the origins of our universe. It's a nation that until recently was closed off to the world, that has transformed itself in incredible ways. From a rural society into the world's factory. Cities have been built to a size and scale not matched in any previous period in world history. Across this vast and inhospitable land, high-tech transportation and highways are built at an incredible pace. Engineering solutions are required to supply the huge amounts of energy that are needed to reduce pollution that's affecting almost half of its nearly 1.4 billion population. Against this ever-changing landscape, millions of Chinese still observe ancient traditions and rites, whilst discovering new forms of leisure and entertainment. China, a vast melting pot of past and present, now revealing itself to the world.